today I'm coming back with another expat life story. I hope you guys enjoy this one. It was not fun for me. I'm going to tell you the story of the first time I ever broke a bone. Why is this an expat story? Because it happened in my first week living abroad. So let's just get started. If you don't know me, my name is Kara. I'm from Pennsylvania, but I am currently living in the Dominican Republic. Last year, I lived in Honduras. That was my first year teaching English abroad and living abroad as a US expat. It was my first week of school. It was a Monday. So this is going to be a fun story of a fun Monday. So in between classes, I would often go to the teacher's lounge, which was in a separate building that also had the auditorium space. So I would go to that building and I would go up the stairs and sit in the teacher's lounge on the second floor. One time I was coming down, I was ready to go to my class. The kids were at recess still. This building had tinted windows, which helped because they had very, very big windows, so it helped make the indoors less hot and less bright. So I came down the stairs from the teacher's lounge. I opened the door and it was so, so bright in my face because I had just been in this building with tinted windows. All I saw was sun in my face. I knew the kids were playing soccer on the basketball court at recess and I was trying to avoid that. Couldn't see where I was going and I stepped sort of to the side and little did I know that there was a little ramp right there. A very small ramp. I'm telling you, it couldn't have been higher than this tall. It couldn't have been taller than this. I stepped on the edge. Half my foot made it on the ramp, half of my foot did not, and I fell on the side of my foot, which was kind of embarrassing in the moment because I was in front of all these students. Luckily, they were nice. One even asked me, they were like, "Oh my gosh, miss, are you okay?" I said, "Yeah, I'm fine, thank you." And I got up, I walked to my class, and yeah, I was kind of in pain, but I just pushed through because that's what I do. I walked to my class, I realized, oh, this kind of hurts. I think it'll get better though with time. It's usually how it works. And I taught the class, but I was so slow. I was walking so slow and as little as possible because it hurt so bad and I didn't want the students to realize anything was wrong. I was still thinking, this will get better. It'll just take time. But by the end of that class, it hurt so bad and it was starting to swell. My foot was not in the shape of a foot anymore. So I went upstairs to where my next class would be, but I had a 45-minute break. There's no way I was going all the way back up the stairs to the teacher's lounge. So I went to the bathroom that was on the same floor as my next class. I went in a stall, I just sat there, and I'm gonna be honest, I shed a tear or two. And I was like, oh no, I'm gonna have to go straight home, ice this, hope and pray it gets better. Yeah, I was still thinking that, even though I was sitting in the bathroom. So I taught my final class of the day, and after that, that's when I realized I should ask where the nurse's office is and see if she can do something for me. I went to a teacher who was standing there, I asked where the nurse's office was, found it, went there, and I explained what happened, how I stepped on the edge of the ramp, I fell, and then I kept walking around, which probably made it worse than it had to be. And she called in one of the principals and the other lady who was also in charge of taking, you know what, please be quiet. And the other lady who was also in charge of taking care of the foreign teachers whenever something happens. And they were both just looking at how swollen my foot was because I'm telling you, it was huge. From there, we went to the doctor's office. I went there with the lady who I mentioned before. They were assuming it was just a sprain. And also everyone kept asking me, were you wearing these shoes? Like they were expecting I was wearing some high heels or something, but no, they were pretty good flats. I mean, flats still aren't the most supportive, but they had good supportive structure to them. But yeah, I was wearing those shoes when that happened. And so I went to the doctors and they thought it was just a sprain. At that point, I was still trying to walk on my foot, like to the cars and to the door and to the doctor's office. But then they told me I just need to stop. I should not be walking on it, putting weight on it anymore. So the doctor there thought it was just a sprain. I explained what happened and they figured it's probably just a sprain because I twisted my ankle pretty bad, but they wanted to have an x-ray just to be sure. So that would require going to the hospital. We did that. I went to the hospital, and once I was at the hospital, they put me in a wheelchair to be able to maneuver me because I should not be walking on it at all. At the hospital, they did the x-ray. I was sitting in the bed waiting for the results of the x-ray, and before I knew it, they came back and they were putting my foot in a cast. Let me just say, that is not how I imagined my first week, my first 2 weeks of living abroad to go. I had never ever broken a bone before, and that was my first time. That had to be the time. They put me in a cast, It went all the way up to my knee, which I felt was excessive because it was just a fracture in one of the bones in the metatarsals in my left foot. I was like, what on earth am I going to do now? So they told me 1 week, no moving around, not doing much. I stayed home from school the rest of that week. And let me just say, they did not send me home from the hospital with crutches. And I had about 10 steps to go to get to my apartment. My other coworker helped me like get up the stairs, like hopping up them one at a time. The whole situation was just ridiculous. Coworkers brought me her leftover pizza and they tried to help me wrap it up in plastic bags and tape it to be able to take a shower. Also, thank God I was wearing loose pants and I didn't have to put on a hospital robe and come home in that or cut my pants open or something. I mean, I would have been the least of my problems in that moment, but just saying. I'm glad it happened that way. I didn't get crutches until the next day when a message in the teacher's chat asking if anyone had an extra pair or, you know, a pair they had lying around, and someone did. They brought them to the school and then they brought them to me so I could get around a little bit better. My apartment did have a little step in it up to the bathroom, but thankfully I had a walk-in shower so it wasn't too bad to bathe myself or anything. And my other coworker brought me something to sit on in the shower so I could wash myself. But I will say, putting a bag on that thing every time I wanted to shower was the most annoying part. After 1 week, I was very nervous to go out because this town was an old town. So the roads were very uneven. They were cobblestone roads. It was not ideal for someone on crutches. Let me just say that. By the end of that week on Friday, my coworkers managed to get me out of the house. I went down half a block to a little store where I sat while I did some shopping. I went and got some ice cream. It felt good to see the light of day, let me say. I was still getting used to the crutches, but then that next week it was right back at school and I was teaching climbing stairs, climbing ramps with those things, and that was for the next 6 weeks or so. I did go back to the doctors a couple times in between that time and the time I got my cast off, just because one time I noticed my toes were purple. I was wondering if that was normal, so I went for that, and then I went another time for getting it off, which was a great relief. I still could not walk properly because my foot and leg had just lost so much muscle. It was very nice to have my foot free, to be able to take a shower normally, and finally be able to walk. Although I still had to use the crutches for at least a week, but then eventually I was off them and I felt so good. I was so happy to be off crutches, although I was still being very, very careful because the roads were cobblestone, like I mentioned, and anyone could fall on those, even someone who's perfectly fine. Finally, after about 8 weeks, it was in August I broke my foot, and then October, finally, I was off crutches, I was walking, and it felt great. That is my story of the first time I ever broke my bone, and it just happened to be the week after I moved abroad for the first time. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It is a story I can definitely laugh about now, even though it was not fun at the time. I just hope this doesn't happen to anyone else, because let me tell you, teaching in a two-story school that does not have an elevator is not ideal. But it's okay, we made it through. All my students were so nice too, always offering to carry my backpack to and from the different classrooms. And of course, the whole time, basically, I was having them write on the board everything, which got to be a bit slow at times, but it was okay. It worked out. I made it through, we survived. I just pray this has not happened to anyone else. Let me know in the comments below if you've had a crazy experience like this, or if you want to hear more stories about life abroad, just crazy things that have happened to me. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.